Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, friends. Welcome back to my channel. I have this Vestel Power Supply 7PW26-4. It is dead. Let's repair it. Meanwhile, I will also explain it how to take approach to troubleshoot it. So I will continue in steps. In first step, we will discuss standby section. Then PFC section, this one, and finally we will discuss its main power stage, and then there are many other power stages. It is difficult to study all the board in one session, so we will divide it in four different sessions. In first step, we will see its input circuit. If you don't have good experience in electronics, never try to repair, because here are live voltage. Always take care for the safety. Never touch any component, even if power supply is removed from the power supply or it is connected, might be this capacitor is holding charge. Before touching to this primary side, this portion, verify voltage on this capacitor. No voltage. If there are voltage, discharge it. You can use any lamp, tungsten lamp, or you can use a very simple discharging kit. The video number is here on the screen. You can watch that video and you can make this simplest capacitor discharging kit. Just only we will connect across the capacitor and it will discharge it. When there are no voltage, it is safe. You can download its circuit diagram by finding this part number and search it, 17PW26-4 circuit diagram. So you will find this circuit diagram on Google, and here is 17PW26-4. This diagram is somewhat different than the other circuit diagrams, because here are links. It is not showing complete wiring diagram of the PCB. It is showing portion wise, and there are links with some heads like this. SW off, then you will find SW off in this diagram that will be connected at that point. So it is best way to make diagram in this way. It makes the diagram simple. When we perform visual inspection, this IC is damaged, IC 806. In the first attempt, I will remove this IC. If you check its part number, it is FSDL321. Input connector, fuse, protections, EMI circuit, bridge rectifier. After bridge rectifier, voltage will reach to this capacitor. Then this voltage will reach to this circuit. It will provide voltage at output, that are standby voltage. When we will make power on signal, that time it's this stage and this stage will turn on, and its other monitoring circuits and other regulators will start to regulate voltage. This power switching IC is damaged. If this IC is damaged, that time we must check fuse. Input terminal, fuse. Fuse, open circuit. Three point one five ampere. PCB marking 3.15 ampere. After this plug, one line is entering in this fuse F800. That is this one. One line reaching directly to this side. Second line after fuse reaching to PL815. Here is also connector. But in this model, there is no connector. Here is jumper. Because this board is used in different models. If there is power switch, that will come here. One wire to that switch. The wire coming out from that switch will reach here. Transient voltage suppressor R801. If due to over voltage stress, any spike, it will become short circuit. That time the fuse will open from here. If any time there is high voltage strike, it will become short circuit. So our circuit will protected by opening this fuse. After this protection, the voltage are reaching to this component, R800. R800 is 10 ohm NTC. It is 10 ohm thermistor. This time it is 6.8 ohms, 6.9 ohms, depending on the temperature. That is this component. Now here we have two paths. The first path, fuse, jumper or switch, then at this point. Here is MOV, resistor, then this thermistor, thermal resistor. Here until here, this inductor, this point. Second path, from the same switch point or jumper point, the current is reaching to this contact. If you see, here is relay. That is this one. If this relay is on, that time it will close this path. The voltage will reach from here. Maybe from this path or maybe from this path. This is used to limit the current at initial stage. When we are powering it on, this capacitor is empty. That time it will create heavy surge current in this line. To protect from any unexpected damage, this resistor becomes in series. When the circuit is clear, this capacitor will hold some good charge. That time this relay will turn on, and so it will bypass this resistor. Neutral reached here. Line after fuse, jumper, NTC at this filter. Here are two filters. L818, L817. Current will pass from these inductors. At this point, there is a capacitor, class Y capacitor, that is connected between neutral point and chassis. This filter between neutral and ground, it is class Y capacitor. Any common mode noise that will come in this line, that will be grounded from here. Any common mode noise in line, that will be eliminated from here. That will be grounded from this capacitor. Class Y capacitors, this one and this one. If you check after fuse, until this inductor, we have 10 ohms NTC. That is this one. Here 0 ohms, here 10 ohm, that 10 ohm here. That means this path is clear. After inductor, 10 ohms. Then it will reach to this point. Now we will see what is here. Neutral is reaching directly here. It will not give continuity with chassis. If it will give continuity with chassis, that time we will find line voltage in the body, in the chassis. The same here. If neutral or line are given continuity with chassis, that time this capacitor or this capacitor is damaged. This inductor is open. This inductor is good. This inductor is open. This inductor, yes, this pin is broken. It is a ferret core and just only piece of wire. This is disconnection. I reduced its one turn. That will not affect too much. But it is much better to use new wire. Yes, now it's good. This one. Now this capacitor and this inductor. These will make differential mod EMI filter. Any noise on both lines will be blocked here and that will be discharged using this tank circuit. Then here are AC1 and AC2 output terminals. One mega ohm 2 resistor, 1 mega ohm 2 resistor, 1 mega ohm 2 resistor. Series parallel connection, these resistors. These are part of EMI circuit. These resistors will create high impedance discharging circuit for EMI. Practically 1004, 1 mega, and here is 2 mega. 1 mega, 1 mega, 1 mega, 2 mega. In circuit, there is 1 mega resistor. All resistors are 1 mega ohm, but practically out of 6, 2 resistors are 2 mega and other are 1 mega. Then these voltage line and neutral are reaching to these inductors. Here are two components, L845 and L846. These inductors are passing the current here to the bridge rectifier. Here is bridge rectifier. Now if we check continuity from here to the input terminal, this line is clear. That means there is no disconnection now. Before this, this choke was disconnected. Second input terminal of the bridge rectifier is not giving continuity here because we removed the fuse. But at this point, there is 10 ohm resistance due to this NTC. Here is bridge rectifier. Bridge rectifier input terminals are in center point. This point, cut side is positive, the second side is ground. This is bridge rectifier negative terminal. Negative terminal is reaching directly to this capacitor, negative terminal. That is main DC capacitor, bulk capacitor here. Positive terminal from here, this jumper, this diode, and it is reaching to this point. That means there is another diode in series with the positive voltage. First I will make jumper for test purpose using 1 ampere bus fuse wire. to bypass the fuse, and then I will arrange this fuse. And finally I will install this fuse so that we will not damage any fuse more. As we discussed, after dual line filter, the voltage are reaching to this filter, that are these two filters, and then voltage will reach to bridge rectifier AC input terminals, that are this one and this one. In some models, maybe this inductor is not available. There will be a jumper. That time it is mentioned S. Might be jumper or might be inductor. Now this positive 400 volt sign, it will go to the main DC capacitor. Voltage will pass through this D898, that is 1N5406 diode. The voltage will reach to main DC capacitor, that is bulk capacitor. Plus 400 volt, and it is C819, 150 microfarad, 450 volt capacitor, that is this one. The same voltage are also entering at this point, that is primary winding of this standby transformer. This positive voltage are reaching directly to this winding, transformer winding. Ground side is connected to source pin of this IC, DL321, that is switching IC, built-in MOSFET. It will switch and it will provide voltage. In next session we will study this standby section. And now we will check bridge rectifier. This is positive terminal of the bridge rectifier. Black lead at positive terminal. One input terminal. Second input terminal. Move lead to negative terminal. Open. Open. Reverse the leads. Red lead at positive terminal. Open, open. Move red lead to negative terminal. One diode, one diode. 0.504. Open. That means bridge rectifier is good. Now I will apply line voltage. Always take care for the safety. I will apply power using series lamp. The lamp takes current and then back to normal. That means the capacitor is charged now. Now if we check DC voltage, we have 337 volt. That means its input circuit is now clear. We are receiving this voltage. If the fuse is open or any component in this series path is open circuit, we will not receive voltage here. AC input 235. Input 235 volt AC RMS at capacitor 337 volt. We will continue in upcoming session to fix this standby section, and we will study that circuit as well. Discharge this capacitor. Yes, now it is safe. If you have not subscribed my channel until now, subscribe it. If this video is informative, give a thumb up. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.